following contest is scheduled for one fall.
There's a couple little hunksters
currently
right
in the
there,
ring,
Brain.
Weighing in at 225 pounds, unhailing from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma.
Woof, woof.
Here is Ed Robinson.
Boy, I wouldn't want to be an Ed Robinson. What's that little runt doing in the world?
Shut up. Everybody something. Listen to me.
Get that guy
from
out
now
of there.
On, nobody announces the man who rules the world.
Uh-oh.
Except for
what?
Me. Harvey Whippleman.
Whippleman?
So I want all Whippleman. Shut of up. You peons to stand up on your feet and show respect to the man who rules the world. Sin. Justice.
Asking everybody to stand up. Was he standing up?
I'm standing.
Looks like to me he was on his knees.
I'm standing, Monsoon.
Why don't you sit down?
But Hulk Hogan's going to be on his knees at WrestleMania, looking up at Big Sid Justice, begging him for mercy.
Take a look at that hunk of humanity. One half of the double main event at WrestleMania 8 as he faces one-on-one the immortal Hulk Hogan. And, of course, the other half for the World Wrestling Federation Championship as your man, Ric Flair, faces former WWF champion, the Macho Man Randy Savage.
Well, it appears to me that Sid Justice is so intense, he wants Hogan real bad. And Savage wants Flair and the title just as bad. WrestleMania 8 Monsoon is going to be something.
Look at this. That's a joke, referee. Give me a break. Ryder, listen to the chant of Hogan here.
I'll tell you, I bet there's one person now telling the people to shut up, and that's Hogan. He don't want any part of Sid Justice.
Well, unlike the Royal Rumble, Brady won't be able to sneak up behind the Hulkster. He'll have to beat him face to face.
Oh, my God. Look at that.
I think you better call the paramedics. Injustice making short work of it. It'll be a little tougher. Come April 5.
I'm the man.
Obviously, schizophrenic tendencies. I can see it in his eyes.
He's nuts. He is crazy. And I don't want to get near him. Look at that.
What's that whip doing with the stethoscope? Let's go back and take a look.
Look at this powerbomb, Monsoon. He's got to be seven, almost 8 feet in the air. Look at this. Again.
He may have terminated that youngster's
You're
career.
You're looking at the man. The man that fears nobody.
A man that fears nobody.
Well, you better take him out of the stretcher. He could have a broken back.
Come on. Hey, Goulet, do something. Stiff in there.
Look at this.
Oh, come on. What a dangerous individual.
Wow.
Here we go to the event center. Take it away.
See, Hulk Hogan, you're running around, you're spouting your big mouth, you're saying to everybody, hey, I've been here. I've seen them come and go. But let me tell you something. See, there's two type of bees in this world. There's a bee that makes honey. And there's like yourself, Fatso, that there used to be. Now I'm the new man around here. I'm the man, when I walk, the ground shakes. I am the man that everyone fears. I am the man in mania who will put an end to Hulkamania. I am the man that rules the world.
You Hulkamaniacs, I've seen the look before. I've seen the look before. When I saw Sid Justice at the press conference, when I saw the look in his eyes, I knew I saw it before. And so I looked at the tape over and over, and finally it came to me. In the middle of the night, I realized that cold stare, the cold blood that runs through his veins. It's the same stare I've seen in the Dahmers of the world, or the Mansons of the world, brother. My God, you've seen what he's done already around the WWF. Who knows, between now and WrestleMania, what he's going to get away from. But we got to stop the thing, man. Hulkamania in its truest form is the only way we can stop this maniac, this madman. That's why, brother, when you step into the world of Hulkamania, you're going to find out that the four commandments that we've lived by through thick and thin will take your eyes first, the third one will take your breath, and the fourth one will take your soul, brother. What you going to do when my brand of justice passes sentence on you?
Now I know you were talking about Mr. Perfect. You were talking about Sensational Jerry, who's the manager of Shawn Michaels, whom we will see a little bit later on. But there you see the manager of IRS and Ted DiBiase, Jimmy Hart, former manager of the Natural Disasters.
You got a hand to that Jimmy Hart. He's pretty smart, isn't he? I don't know about that, but now we see the belt around the waist of the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, and the belt around IRS, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship belt. And what representatives they're gonna be, McMahon. Great wrestling style, both of them. They're wrestlers, McMahon. I like that style.
Yeah, I see the gold. That's the gold that Jimmy Hart sold Natural Disasters down the river for.
That the residents of Florida started paying a state income tax.
He's right about that, McMahon.
You mean there's no state income tax in the state of Florida?
Not to my knowledge.
Well, someone's going to be paying some dues, no doubt, and I would suggest to you that the team of IRS and DiBiase are going to be paying the dues at WrestleMania when they face the Natural Disasters, and I think, for one, Jack Tunney, no doubt, made a wise decision in stating that the first title defense of IRS and DiBiase would be against the Natural Disasters.
Well, McMahon, I've said all along that the Natural Disasters are the biggest team in the World Wrestling Federation and also the most devastating, McMahon. This is going to be a heck of a matchup.
Indeed, and now the Natural Disasters doing it on their own without the anchor or assistance, depending upon your point of view, of Jimmy Hart. Jimmy Hart continues to manage the tag team of the Nasty Boys, as well as now the tag... Oh, look at that.
This is easy money, baby. Easy money.
Yeah, well, you took the money, Jimmy Hart. You outmaneuvered Natural Disasters, took them out of contention, and then from there took the dirty money from DiBiase and IRS and moved them into contention.
Everybody's got a price, McMahon.
Yeah, well, there's no doubt Jimmy Hart had a price. IRS and Ted DiBiase, the WWF Tag Team Champions. Look out here. Terry Davis, ooh, and there is the write-off.
Forget about it.
And it's history. So DiBiase and IRS pick up a bit of momentum as they head to WrestleMania to face the awesome combination of Earthquake, Typhoon, the Natural Disasters, and it could very well spell disaster for the newly crowned Tag Team Champions of the World Wrestling Federation. Enjoy those belts while you can, boys. They may not be around your waist very long. Let's take you now to the update.
Oh, Jake Roberts, you made a fatal mistake when you visited my funeral parlor. Now you'll deal with my undertaker.
The day of reckoning will soon be at hand. At WrestleMania, Snake Roberts, you must meet the Reaper.
Well, we're back, and I believe what we're going to hear now is Sensational Sherry actually singing the entrance music here. Here they come.
Now, will you be quiet, McMahon, for a minute and listen to Sherry? She sounds better than Madonna. She has really got a voice on her.
That's Sensational Jerry singing,
McMahon. Listen, will ya?
Boy, toy.
Oh, that gives me the goosebumps.
What gives you the goosebumps? Never mind. What is, look at this. This guy slays me. Who does he think he is? Earrings,
That's total confidence, McMahon. Take a look at this, Shawn Michaels. I really enjoy watching this guy. I think he's one of the greatest wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation right now.
You do. We had an occasion to, speak with him earlier on. Here's what they had to say.
El Matador, you remember when your old man lost the job, the mother had to take care of the kids, the house burnt down, and a bank repoed the car, and the whole family had to move into your aunt's Chevy? Come WrestleMania 8 at Indianapolis in the Hoosier Dome, you're going to remember those as the good old days.
He tells it the way it is, doesn't he?
The good old days?
Well,
I don't know about that.
It's not going to get any better for Tito Santana. At WrestleMania, Shawn Michaels has showed me, and I think he's proved to everybody, that he is one of the greatest wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation right now. And take a look at that. There's a great example of it right there, McMahon.
Yes, I'll agree with you, but don't take anything away from Tito Santana. El Matador, if you would.
Well, Shawn Michaels has the ability to adjust his talents to whomever he's wrestling. Like right there, McMahon, he took the guy's head off with a drop kick.
Indeed he did. But what will happen when he locks up with El Matador? Unfortunately for Scott Hannon, he's going to be looking right into the eyes, yes, of Sensational Sherry. He's mesmerized from the far side. Wait a minute. Oh, yeah. Look at that maneuver.
There you go, McMahon. That's why Sensational Sherry is such a threat outside. You take your eyes off your opponent for 1 minute. Shawn Michaels took advantage of it.
And every time he will take advantage of every situation, Shawn Michaels, if nothing else, other than being a great wrestler, is unquestionably an opportunist.
And there's nothing wrong with that, McMahon.
Ooh, what a devastating maneuver. However, there's nothing wrong with the skills of El Matador.
Oh, I'm not taking anything away from El Matador, but he is just outmatched, outclassed. This Shawn Michaels, I told you earlier, he's one of... Look at this here, McMahon.
Oh, he dumped him backwards. Suplex. Oh, look at that cover.
That's confidence.
No, that's haughtiness. That's what that is. And what that is... It's Sensational Sherry, and we are hearing Sensational Sherry sing.
Boy, she has a lot of different talents, doesn't she?
I suppose. Look at this. Just my sexy boy. Boy toy.
Take a look at this move, McMahon. Up and around into a backbreaker. What a great wrestling move. And then this, off the apron with a clothesline. And then this, right on the back of your neck. That'll put your lights out.
Indeed, that'll... Where
come
are
on,
we now?
Come on, get out of here. If you see us, watch us. It's a full July. Oh, it's a little cold in here. A little cold in here. Get that around me, honey. Warm me up. They really love me out there, don't they?
They're going to love you.
Of course they do. Of course they do. Come on, bud. Let's get out of here, okay? A little privacy, huh? A little treat for you. A little treat for you, huh? All right. It's
going to
be a good night for us, isn't it? Ain't always.
Give me a break. Shawn Michaels and his manager.
Quiet, McMahon. I have an announcement to make. Shawn Michaels has left the building.
What?
You know something, Sid Justice? You and Whippleman, as demented as you are, brother, are not even going to face the power of Hulkamania. This is where it all started, and this is where it's all going to end. Right on WrestleMania with you, brother. You know, it's like history repeating itself, man. I remember when I was a little teeny Hulkster hanging out on Venice Beach, California. I heard the screams. I heard everybody panicking, running for their lives, coming out of water. And then as I started to dog paddle out past the buoys, I faced the killer head on, the killer shark. I bit him right between the dorsal fin. And as I was dog paddling, brother, back to get a pina colada at Trader Vic's, I realized I had an extra passenger. Just like Whippleman is sucked onto you, brother, this shark had a scavenger onto his belly to suck up all the trash and the slime and everything that he left behind. Well, you know something, brother? At WrestleMania, I'm going to face you head on, just like the killer shark. And you and that little scum Whippleman, you're going to be history at some garbage dump, brother, in Indianapolis. What you going to do when the Hulksters and my little maniacs backstroke on you?
I don't lie, I don't steal, I don't beg, and I doggone well fight as well as anybody. Bret Hart, you're a nice guy. I don't particularly want to fight you, but I'm telling you right to your face. I'm going to rip your throat out if you show up April 5th in the Hoosier Dome, and I'm telling you, I feed my kids this way. I made it real clear to you. I like you. I like everything about you, but this is what I do for a living. Comes right down to it, Brett, the hitman Hart. I'll hit him, man. Roddy Piper, I kind of know how you feel. This fight on April 5th in WrestleMania 8, it's not a fight that I want. It's a fight that I have to have. I have to win back the World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Belt, and that means I gotta go through you. Sure, you've been a friend of mine, you've been a hero of mine, but it's time for me to stand up and show the world who is the World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion. We're gonna throw out all the respect, we're gonna throw out all the friendship. In WrestleMania 8, I'm walking out with the belt.
Thus far signed up for WrestleMania.
Wait a minute, what's this?
We know who that is. And we know who this is, Harvey Whippleman. Sid Justice rules the world, huh?
Any of you idiots, the poor!
He is a big man, McMahon.
Cut the music! Give me the letter, Harvey. Open it up if you would. Hey, if you morons can just quiet a second, I have something to say.
Then say it.
Hello. This little sixth grader sent me a letter the other day, and it just really breaks my heart. It says, Sid, I've been a Hulkamaniac since I don't know when. Me and my friends, they want to know why I turned my back on Hulk Hogan. They don't understand, see, because they're stupid too. How could you destroy Brutus the Barber Beefcake and destroy the barber shop when you know you were going to hit him in his face and his face was already hurt? This brings a tear to my eye. And if you can't be a friend to the Hulkster, you can't be my friend either. Well, see, it's real simple. If you're afraid of Hulk Hogan, you are no friend of mine.
I don't know if this guy has any friends at all. Sid Justice all over his opponent, Mickey J.
Look at the size of this guy, McMahon.
I know, he's awesome, no doubt about it. He could very well cast a shadow in size only over the Hulkster, but he won't be casting a shadow over Hulkamania. I assure you of that.
Well, you can't assure anybody of that, McMahon. This guy is 6'10". Look at the ashes.
Harvey dumps the ashes on this guy's chest and burns his chest.
Well, he didn't want to get any on the mat.
Oh, I see, yeah.
Ooh, no. This guy means
now
business,
he gave
McMahon.
You if you touch this little guy, you answer to me.
I don't think anyone wants to be touching that little guy, that's for sure. Not if you have to answer to Sid Justice. Sid Justice now. Cinching up his opponent, Mickey J. This is Hulk Hogan, he just said. Powerbomb to the canvas.
God.
And the count. And a big smile on Harvey's face.
Boy, I hope Hulk Hogan is watching this, McMahon.
Hulk Hogan to meet Sid Justice. What is this, Dr. Whippleman now? Well, they want to make sure his heart is still beating. Oh, yeah, sure. Sid Justice, they're bringing out the stretcher. Sid Justice on his way to WrestleMania, on his way to lock up with Hulk Hogan.
Wow.
Let's go back and take another look at the way Sid Justice polished off Mr. J.
Well, here you see right here, McMahon. He's got the guy bent over. He lifts this guy 7 feet in the air. It's the power bomb, and the lights are out.
And that is unquestionably enough to lock. Hey, come on. The guy's on a stretcher. What is this? Call 911. What's Harvey doing? He's putting a Hulkamania headband on his...
Wait a minute, Sid Justice! Kicks to the chest, and down goes that poor unfortunate Mickey J.
Trying to set an example, Sid Justice is...
There's your Hulk Hogan! There's Hogan! He's a loser! He's a stinking coward!
That remains to be seen, Mr. Justice. I just hope justice is served.
As part of the greatest wrestling extravaganza of all time, WrestleMania 8, my guest this week is going to be facing in a one-on-one matchup, The Undertaker. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jake the Snake Roberts.
Going to be a bad day at the Hoosier Dome for Jake the Snake.
Trust me. This is going to be interesting.
Look at that sound.
You know, Jake Roberts, we're all well aware of the fact that you're familiar with the dark side. However, I'm very curious if you're familiar with the inside of a coffin.
What a tangled web we weave when first we labor to deceive. A little snake spear for you there, Okerlund. A little snake spear.
I don't know what in the world you were thinking, Jake Roberts. Grabbing that steel chair, as people all over the world have seen, and repeatedly pummeling The Undertaker time and time again.
Now you should know me better than that. Hitting The Undertaker with that chair was just a little foreplay, if you don't mind, you know? Having a little fun for myself. Let me tell you something, Undertaker. If the Winter Olympics had an event for clubbing seals, I would win the gold medal. Now, what I'm trying to tell you and what I'm trying to tell Undertaker is this. All of my life, I have been on the other side of the fence, the dark side. He says he's on the dark side. No, you're not quite there, brother. You've never walked the line that I have. You've never rode that razor's edge. What I'm trying to tell you, Undertaker, is I walk with Satan hand in hand day by day. We've always been very close. But at WrestleMania 8 in Indianapolis, at the Hoosier Dome, just like those poor, helpless little seals that flounder on the ice, I will take that hammer and I will crush your stinking skull. It's that simple. Now, after I've crushed your skull, I'm going to take you and that geek, the pallbearer, and put both of you, on that funeral pyre. That pilot light, it will go up, and I will take this hand, and I will put it on that lever, that sweet lever, the one that turns up the gas, and roast the both of you, brother. And then I will send both of you to that lovely place I call hell.
Seals? Don't hit back. The Undertaker will.
Oh, Jake Roberts, you slithered your way into our funeral parlor and tried to dance to our music. Now it's time to pay the band.
Snake Roberts, the price for betraying us will be the largest funeral ever witnessed, WrestleMania.
Just who do you think you are, Ric Flair? You said you had relationship. How dare you, Ric Flair? That kind of information, it's that kind of conduct, it's despicable. Certainly unbecoming of someone of your stature as the World Wrestling Federation champion.
What you're seeing here, McMahon, is the arrogance of the World Wrestling Federation champion, the arrogance of a man that knows he's on top of every aspect of life, a man whose word is unreproachable, a man who right now is holding what could be a collector's item by tomorrow. Recognize this magazine? You know why it could be a collector's item by tomorrow? Because Randy Savage is at a fever pace trying to buy every issue on the street. Would you be embarrassed? He's embarrassed. You know why? Because we're revealing the fact that his wife did not lead a life of celibacy. That there was life before Randy. That there was, well, look at this picture right here. Here we are in her living room, on her sofa, where we spent so many enjoyable hours. Me with my huge arm nestled around her shoulder, watching a program I was no fan of back then. Do you recognize the two people there? Well, that's you and my financial advisor, Bobby Heenan, TNT. Once again, the evidence rolls on. Let's look at another photo right here. Here we are, playing billiards. That's pool to you. Actually, I'm teaching her, as I taught her so many other things. You know, she had a real palatial crib. Right off to the right of this table, you can't see the picture is her bedroom.
We're not gonna talk about that.
Oh, we'll talk about anything I want to. I'm a WWF champion. Have you forgotten? Let's go back to the original scene. Here we are. Let me assure you of one thing, McMahon. The temperature in her pool is second to none. But let's look real closely here at the hottest item going. You see those two towels, right? R and L, Rick and Liz. As the story rolls on, McMahon, Randy and Liz, I understand there's a lot of dissension in that marriage right now. Randy, don't be ashamed of that feeling. Nobody can walk in these.
Randy Savage, let me first of all thank you for allowing us into your home during a time that has to be very difficult for both Elizabeth and yourself. And I respect the wishes of Elizabeth not wanting to appear on camera at this time. But what about the allegations from Ric Flair? You saw it in front of a nationwide television audience on Entertainment Tonight. I mean, the photographs showing he and your wife at poolside, watching television together, nestled on the couch, even playing billiards. Very intimate situations indeed. And then Ric Flair saying that Elizabeth, well, let me quote him. Randy, he said, she was mine, Randy Savage, before she was yours. I really don't know what to say. You know, the very image of Elizabeth, and then that storybook relationship between you and her, all of this now coming into question.
I've done my time, boss man. My sentence is almost up. And soon, real soon, you're gonna pay. Then I'll be completely rehabilitated.
Hogan, you wanted him, you got him.
It's 3 weeks away. Imagine you're sitting there, Hogan, with a feeling in your gut like somebody just stomped a hole in it. You know what that feeling is? It's fear. It's fear that you know that you now have to be the man that you say that you are. You have to prove to the world that you're not a coward. You have to face me one-on-one. I finally get my chance to put my hands around your throat, and I'm going to lift you up, and I'm going to drive you into the ground, and you'll look up at me, and you'll say, Sid, you rule the world.
You know something, maniacs, what I think about 3 weeks away, brothers, it's like an eternity. It's like forever and a day. Because this is the day that wrestling like Hulkamania either lives forever or it's all downhill. You know something? Yet, Sid Justice, we don't know if you're a man or a mouse. We don't know if you're a redwood tree that you possess to be that can stand the test of time. Or if you're like the cowardly lion, Winnie Pooh, that eats up on my tail. You know something, Sid Justice? Every Everything you've done since you've got in the WWF has been a cowardly act, brother. Thank God the hierarchy at the Titan Tower on Exit 9 have finally got behind Hulk Hogan. Because if you didn't go with the four demands this time, wrestling, your job, your lifestyle, the WWF, it's all over, man. Sid Justice, Hulk Hogan's gonna pay you a visit at WrestleMania. And what you're gonna do when Hulk Hogan, the Maniacs, and the whole WWF run wild on you?
Jake the Snake Roberts, the clock on my embalming room wall is ticking down. Only 3 weeks away to WrestleMania. Oh, yes, there'll be a funeral in Stone Mountain, Georgia.
Snake Roberts, you came to us asking of the secrets of the dark side. And what you learned, you tried to use for your personal gain. Now the running's over. Now, 3 weeks, you meet the Reaper at WrestleMania.
We're back with this more action. Hey, McMahon, what's this I hear? You're the host of a new TV show.
Yeah, Body Stars.
Body Stars. Now, McMahon, what could be more perfect than Mr. Perfect when you talk about bodies? The guy with the perfect body. And who knows more about nutrition and the right things to eat? The perfect things to eat. And who knows more about bodybuilding lifestyles than yours truly, Mr. Perfect? If you would let me be the co-host on that show, well, I'd have myself as the first star on there.
I have no doubt you would. And there, ladies and gentlemen, is an awesome creature.
Nobody announces the next man except for me. You got that? I want all you idiots to show the respect to the man.
Find out if he rules Hulkamania when he locks up with the Hulkster at WrestleMania at the Indianapolis Hoosier Dome.
McMahon, I think everybody is going to witness. Finally, Hulk Hogan and all the Hulkamaniacs are going to be wiped out. This Sid Justice means business, and Hulk Hogan, it's over.
I am the manager and the personal physician of the man who rules the world.
Really, Harvey. And there is no doubt this man is vicious, to say the least. To the outs. Oh, come on. Those ashes from the cigar burning the back of the... Oh, look at that.
I told you, if you touch the little guy, you answer to me.
You see what happened there, McMahon?
No one touched the little guy.
Yeah,
oh, no, don't do that. Oh, no, down into the back.
He was going to try to get his hands on Harvey, and Sid didn't let it happen.
Oh, come on. Does someone have to stop Sid Justice?
I think the referee is afraid of this guy, McMahon.
With good reason. Sid Justice meeting the Hulkster. Will it be the final chapter of Hulkamania?
Of course.
Fans all over the world are headed to Indianapolis. They want to see it live. They want to witness what's going to happen when the Macho Man Randy Savage locks up with Ric Flair for the WWF champion. They're going to want to know what happens when Hulk Hogan collides with Sid Justice.
Well, McMahon, all you got to do is take a look at this guy. I think Hulk Hogan is scared. I think Hulkamania is over. 2-3.
I don't know what remains to be seen, but there's no doubt Justice has tremendous momentum moving into WrestleMania. Here we're just 3 weeks away from the one-on-one encounter, Justice versus Hogan. And unfortunately, after that power bomb, what is this personal position stuff? Oh, yeah, sure. As if you're giving the last rites to Hulkamania.
His leg's still moving there. Here you see it, McMahon. He's got the guy 7 feet in the air, right onto the back of his head. And then here it is, a power bomb. Nobody's getting up from that.
And finally, they're taking this young man out. Wait a minute, what's this? Hey, come on, leave the guy alone. Call 911. The Hulkamania, we've seen this before.
Call 911.
Sid Justice and Harvey Whippleman. Oh, wait a minute, they're coming down to help out this young man here. Virgil, one of the individuals out there helping out. And Harvey's out there. Harvey just blew smoke into Virgil's face.
Well, he's been...
Woo from behind! You see Justice hammering Virgil from behind.
He was going for Harvey Whippleman.
This is what happened.
Well, now we are going to see what happens to you, all right? Come on, Virgil. Virgil, come on. You can do it. Get up, Virgil. Come on. Let him have it. Turn around. Oh, yes. To the midsection. Knee lift. Slumping in the rope is Virgil. To the far side. Back. Missing. Right back down. Oh, no.
Oh.
Sid giving Harvey Whippleman notice.
This is what happens if you stick your nose in my business.
He's giving notice to Harvey Whippleman to take the pad away from the corner.
Get up, you pig! Get
out! Virgil caught from behind on the outside by Sid Justice. You can hear this unanimous chant. Right in the face,
McMahon. This guy shows no mercy, McMahon.
And a kick to the ribs, and Virgil still holding his face to the outside. Someone, something has to stop Sid Justice. He's out of control.
I'm Sid Justice! And Sid Justice rules the world!
You know, I can't help but think, what would have happened? What would this man have done to Brutus the Barber Beefcake?
Well, I'll tell you, McMahon, you saw what he did to Virgil. He ran his face into the steel around the ring rope. If he does that to Beefcake's face, it will explode into a million pieces. Then again, maybe Beefcake won't even be Hulk Hogan's friend to the end anymore, huh?
Well, you can't blame the guy for trying to stay clear of Sid Justice. Sid Justice is indeed a force to reckon with here in the WWF. I, for one, want to see the match live. I want to see what happens when Hulk Hogan gives Sid Justice a lesson in real justice. I want to witness it at the Hoosier Dome. I want to see it done.
And ladies and gentlemen, my guests this week are going to be involved in what I think is going to be one of the great classic matchups as part of that star-studded card at WrestleMania 8. It's going to be for the Intercontinental Champion. First of all, introducing the challenger, Bret the Hitman Hart.
Former Intercontinental Champion.
He wants it back.
Real bad.
And has got the tools, as far as I'm concerned, Brain, to do just that.
The last thing he wants is to have a match of this importance and not beat a guy in a skirt.
It's called a kilt for your...
Look at that, a picture of Bret Hart, picture of Piper. Friends, question
right
mark.
Now,
I wonder.
From the champion.
Oh, I think they are.
Champion, Rowdy.
They may have mutual respect for each other, but I don't think they care about friendship. He wants to hold on to that gold, and Bret Hart wants to take it. That simple. It's business. Matter of business.
Everything is business to you.
Dollars and cents.
Yep.
Look, he's carrying his skirt now.
Kill. I'm going to tell him what you said.
Roddy Piper, Intercontinental Champion, you are not wearing your kilt this week.
I'll tell you,
First of all, it's always nice to see the folks. And only time I wear my kilt is when I'm going to fight. And I'll tell you something. I didn't come here to talk about fighting today. Come here, sit down. Come here, sit down. Sit down, sit down.
Bret Hart, if you would, please.
Please, please. Bret, come here and sit down. Sit down. I didn't come here to talk about fighting. Actually, I come here to talk about something the whole world could use is not fighting. It's what I talked about, you know. Bret, I know you, doggone it, man. I know you since you've been about this high, man. I know you. Matter of fact, I might have changed diapers one time. I'm not positive, man. But I got to tell you, you know, in this fight, April 5th in WrestleMania, I'm going to back out. I'm not fighting there. I'm gonna give this one up. I'm not going to be in the Hoosier Dome. No. Don't give me no booze now back there. Let me explain something here. Let me explain something. You know, wait, please. I'll tell you something. You know, with Bret Hart here, I've known him for years. I know one time, I'll tell you one time, there was about 40 of us wrestlers, man. And we come to Bret Hart's house about 11 o'clock at night, and Bret Hart's mom, she come down in her bathrobe, man. She started making sandwiches faster than submarine could, man. And she fed us all, and she took care of us, and I sent her flowers, and she sent me a card, and I love your mom. I love your mom. And, you know, I guess if a guy could pick his mama, I'd pick your mama as a mama. I love her, and I can't find it in my heart to go out there and fight you. So I'm not gonna, man. I'm not gonna go to WrestleMania. I'm not gonna fight. I'm just gonna give the bye, man.
With all due respect, Roddy, you gotta understand, if you don't fight me, that means this belt's mine. That means the Intercontinental Championship's been forfeited. That means this is my belt.
Wait a minute. Hold it, folks. Do we have a new Intercontinental Champion before WrestleMania even starts?
Oh, everybody out of the pool. You shut up, and I don't think you understand what I'm saying to you. What I'm saying to you is you're a real nice man, and you come from a family of legends, and I know they're legends. And I know you fought your way, but I fought my way off the street, out of the gutter. I fight for keeps. Let me tell you to your face, if I'm going to fight you, if you think I'm going to go and shake hands with you April 5th in the Hoosier Dome and be real nice about it, you're full of baloney. If you're that serious about it and you want to fight, then you better shake hands now, because from now till April 6th, I'm going to hate your guts, and I'm going to do everything I can to destroy you. It's your choice. You stick your hand out and shake mine, you've got to fight. If you don't, the nice thing would be, let's let it ride, and let's have a nice friendship.
Somebody do something.
I guess I'll see you April 5th.
Okay. All right, champ. I'll see you April 5th.
All right, Edson Braddon, ladies and gentlemen.
Whoa!
Hey. Let's go.
You want to go?
Yeah.
You don't need to do that stuff from behind. We can do it right here, right now.
You know what, Bret? I would have had you, Bret. Come April the 5th, Hoosier Dome, I'm playing for keeps, Bret. See you later. But remember, I would have had you, Bret. I would have had you.
What a matchup that's going to be at the Hoosier Dome, WrestleMania 8.
Why are we so different? What makes you tick? What makes me tick? Who really cares? A lot of questions need to be answered. Maybe WrestleMania 8 will find out some answers to those questions. One question in a lot of people's mind is, why didn't I make a big target right in your forehead and nail you, big man, when I had the chance? Well, I'll tell you something. There's some things even I won't do. Clubbing baby seals is one. But I'll tell you something about them. When they're flopping around the ice and somebody walks up with a hammer and they drop that hammer on their head and they crush their little stinking skulls, why? They're doing a job.
Well, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do the job in Indianapolis on you. Why? Because I've got to. For survival. And after what I owe you, man, you ruined my party. Remember? I had the chair up ready to crack Elizabeth, and you ruined the party.
Right into the hearts of everybody.
Here is the Undertaker!
A huge, powerful man, Gorilla.
I hear some cheers for the Undertaker, don't you?
Yes, he definitely has his own cheering section. He has proven to be such a stalwart fellow in the ring that you cannot help in many ways to admire him, although from a very safe distance.
Got tremendous attributes, tremendous credentials. Size, speed, agility, stamina. And I believe formaldehyde running through his veins.
Yes, that last one, I'm sure you're absolutely right. He is so impervious to punishment, you can never read how much he's hurt. And that in the ring is a tremendous asset. Mustafa watching him extremely cautiously. Mustafa has been a great wrestler in his time.
Look at that, the bell hadn't even rung there, and Mustafa tried to get in a cheap shot. That could be the beginning of the end for him, your lordship. Oh, here it comes, Tombstone City. Oh. He's knocked out.
Oh, my word.
It's over. Oh. Could be a record here.
Oh, I'm sure that must be.
Let's go up and get the official word.
Here's your winner, The Undertaker!
Of course, The Undertaker will not have it that easy in the Hoosier Dome on April 5th at WrestleMania 8 as he faces Jake the Snake Roberts. What a match that's going to be! What an albatross he's got hanging around his neck, Alfred.
You know, somehow, Gorilla, I hate to do this, but I must disagree because Sensational Sherry has aided so many men in their careers. She certainly has a lot of wisdom, if not actual virtue.
And physically helped them as well.
I can't discuss that.
Well, I can. I certainly can. How many times have we seen her interfere in Ted DiBiase's matches?
Well, you know, that's something you have to take into account when you go into that ring. You're not only going against this man who's so superb in everything he does, Shawn Michaels.
Got a tattoo right on her chest. Did you see that, Alfred?
No, I didn't see that.
Well, do you see it there? Right on her left pec. She's got a tattoo there. What is that? A butterfly?
I have no idea. I have absolutely no idea. I've never noticed that before. Shawn Michaels a little bit fussy about his hairstyle.
What a prima donna this guy is. Here for Davey Boy, the British Bulldog, winner of the coveted Samovar Trophy at the Royal Albert Hall in London. Was it last summer, your lordship?
Yes, last October, actually, it was the 4th. What an incredible night that was for Bulldog Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog. He really lived up to all the great expectations that the British public had come to expect of him. And now, here is the world international public here in West Palm Beach, and they're hoping that possibly the Bulldog might bring off something here against Shawn Michaels. Very even match this
time. Well, both of these men with dates with destiny at WrestleMania 8 on April 5th at the Hoosier Dome, a Sunday afternoon, Indianapolis, Indiana. British Bulldog taking on the Berserker. That'll be something. And of course, Shawn Michaels meets Tito Santana and El Matador. Classic confrontation.
Two great matches.
I understand that Sherry also has eyes for Tito.
I don't know about that. I think she's completely enamored, mind you, with Shawn Michaels now, which might be some sort of a disability for that team, because when you're so enamored with one particular person, sometimes you lose sanity in your judgment.
I think that's one of the reasons DiBiase dumped her. He had that roving eye. Look at that, 360, and down to the concrete.
Boy, he's angry. Angry indeed. I believe that tattoo is a heart.
A heart? Mm-hmm. She's got a heart on her.
Yes, she does have a heart on her chest.
I think it's kind of unique. Well, she's upset. Her meal ticket went down there like a ton of bricks.
Do you think she looks upon him as a meal ticket and not, say, as a lover?
I understand she's got quite a bit of bread salted away, shall we say.
Oh, definitely. Oh, boy. With the million-dollar man, she made a fortune.
Ripped him off left and right. Couldn't keep track of his money to save his life.
She's not the only one to have done that, mind you, but she did it in excelsis. Bulldog doing extremely well here. And you said that he will be going against the Berserker on April the 5th.
Yeah, a very strange individual. Berserker, very dangerous, only because of his fungus size, Lordship.
Yes, and he's a rampager, is he not?
He certainly is. And of course, anybody that's under the tutelage of Mr. Fuji is dangerous.
Yes, they combine a little deceitfulness there as well. The Devious One certainly knows how to teach his men in that particular art.
Little leverage move coming up here, I do believe. Oh, there it is.
Oh, gosh. Incredible power.
You don't have any choice with that, Lordship. You go or you break your wrist, your elbow, your shoulder.
Yes.
All in the same move.
Obviously, one of the more dangerous moves there is in the World Wrestling Federation arenas.
Nice block of the hip lock by Davey. You got to have momentum to get that going. That was a nice escape there. Whoa! There she is, up on the apron.
And a momentary distraction there by Sherry caused the downfall of the British Bulldog just as he was beginning to stamp his authority on this belt.
Well, with her out there, it's like two against one.
Gorilla, it's awfully difficult to keep your focus on your opponent when she is out there. You're absolutely right about that. She's maybe not such an asset to Shawn Michaels at all times, but there she proved that she was at that particular time. She's got hearts all over.
Wrapped up tighter than a drum, too, you know, Jim. Look at this. Elbow finds the mark right in the sternum. Valuable time being wasted here.
Yes, and I'm sure the Matador is watching this match and taking that into account. Maybe if you can get Shawn Michaels to do a little showboating, you can slow the tempo of this match down.
Well, it would be to your advantage, no question, but I don't think there's anybody that's going to outspeed Tito Santana inside that squared circle, even Shawn Michaels.
No, he certainly knows how to move around the ring at an alarming rate of speed, El Matador. But Shawn Michaels, he really is getting my vote here for what he's doing in this match. His accuracy is just superb.
Oh, look at this nice leverage move. Got a handful of tights to make it work, but it worked nonetheless.
And no admonition there from the referee. Was he unsighted? Or look at this.
Look at that, harassment.
He's allowing his attention to be diverted again.
Look at it!
Oh, my word.
Right into the steel barricade.
Oh, gosh. That is a damaging blow indeed, delivered there by Shawn Michaels. And the British Bulldog really does have to keep his attention on that one particular man and away from Sherry.
Double axe handle right to the back of the neck. Could have got him here, no. Close, but no cigar.
He didn't snag that leg, Gorilla, like you always advise young wrestlers to do. But nice moves here being shown by Shawn Michaels.
Look at that, that's a choke, Albert. Right underneath the chin there.
He's kind of close. The referee's not checking it, though, so maybe he sees...
There, he's over there watching Sherry.
Well, maybe he sees a little more than we do.
And she doesn't leave much to the imagination.
Down in your bubble head.
Listen to that voice.
Oh,
like to wake up in the morning to that.
Oh, golly. I'll have it all day long.
Woo. Wow, thumb right in the eye.
Michael is really controlling this middle part of this bout here. This last few minutes, he's controlled absolutely everything. It looks like he's going to finish Bulldog off here.
Second turnbuckle on the inside.
And he's measuring. He really is taking too much time, but measured it beautifully, though. Right on the sternum.
Doesn't bother to hook the leg once again, and Davey Boy, no trouble in kicking out. Going up again.
Another nicely measured shot coming up here by Shawn Michaels.
Too long. Took too long to do that. Now Davey Boy on the offense. Whoa. Come on, ref, that's illegal.
It was also a desperation move. Michaels must be feeling
Whoa.
It.
Concrete and rammed into the steel barricade. British Bulldog is upset. Oh, look at this press slam. Oh. Shawn Michaels will be singing considerably higher in the shower, your lordship.
And he may be singing Uncle too shortly if this tremendous assault by the Bulldog continues.
That's an automatic disqualification in my book. Referee's called for the bell. And Sherry is now part of this match.
Whether she likes it or not, you're absolutely right, Gorilla. But surely an English gentleman wouldn't do anything to a lady.
Power slam! That's no lady, your lordship. Oh, look at that. Shawn Michaels just grabbing the leg. Trouble here. Let's get the official word in this one.
The winner of this bout, the British Bulldog.
British Bulldog victorious on a disqualification as Sherry stuck her big nose right in the middle of that match and are going to go home with the short end of the money.
Well, they certainly are, but I don't know whether that was really necessary or not because Michaels was doing very well. He'd taken one or two heavy, heavy blows at the end of that match, but there's no knowing whether he could have come back or not. And I'm afraid Sherry was rather presumptuous and very, very quick to stick her nose in, her nice, pretty little nose, as opposed to what you said, Gorilla.
That big, fat honker heard she stuck it right in there and cost her man the match. Plenty more action still to come. We'll be back in just a moment.
I'm looking for the boat. Make that the yacht of World Wrestling Federation champion Ric Flair. As you know, in recent weeks, Flair has been releasing some rather revealing photographs of him and Elizabeth in some rather intimate situations. All of this in an attempt, an obvious attempt, to affect the performance of the Macho Man when Randy Savage meets Ric Flair for the World Wrestling Federation title 2 weeks from now at WrestleMania. Well, it says, Gypsy, this must be the boat.
This is the right one, you little swabby. Permission to come aboard.
All the way.
Well, this thing's got to be 80 feet long at least.
Welcome aboard, Gene.
Ric Flair. Wow. Boy, is this befitting of the World Wrestling Federation champion. This is lavish.
Did you expect anything less? Have a seat. You staying for the party tonight?
The reason I'm here, Ric Flair, last week I spoke...
It doesn't make any difference. It was on Entertainment Tonight. You saw it. Yeah. Look right here, Gene. Here we are. Look at this.
Wow, where was that?
At her dining room table. Dom Perignon. She's really working on me here, you know. Look at the look in her eyes. Have you ever seen a woman more content in your entire life? And look at here at the stables.
Oh.
There she is with her two favorite studs.
Jeff, I guess you were her first mate, huh?
Yeah, something like that, Mr. Perfect. Damaged goods. Let's go back here one more time.
Oh, my.
Remember I told you about the towels at the pool? The initials R&L? Rick and Liz. And look at here. She even remembered my favorite fruit, strawberries. Cracking up, Savage. You having a hard time swallowing this? Gene, you know that he is. And you know why? Because 2 weeks from now, you're going to be damaged goods just like Elizabeth. You got to walk that out. You got to face the best wrestler alive today, the WWF Heavyweight Champion, WrestleMania 8. You having a problem following this, Savage? Huh. It's a problem you have to live with the rest of your life. I'm Ric Flair. Elizabeth knows that, and you're not. That's something you got to live with. Remember this, Savage. I'm going to dump you. Just like I dumped her, you two deserve each other. Damaged goods, live together the rest of your life. I'm Ric Flair, and I'm riding high. Woo!
We all will be headed to WrestleMania, and here comes a young man who no doubt will be making his way to the Indianapolis Hoosier Dome. As a matter of fact, the face of man, as we said it earlier on, the bottle, Rick Martel.
You go make fun of his hair and see what happens.
I'll do it from here.
Yeah, right. Tatanka, one fiery, full-blooded Native American. And what a matchup that's going to be. Tatanka and Martel going at it. We just got a little taste of what we're likely to see in the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis, where all roads will lead just 2 weeks from now. Tatanka. And Sanchez's opponent going at it now. Shoulder block, that goes Sanchez. The puck off the rough. Coming right back to the near side. And puts the brakes on. Nice great partial. Nice hip drop. Yes, the talk of the war cry. And there you see, ladies and gentlemen, the cover of the current edition of the WWF magazine.
You know, McMahon, this is the best-selling issue of all time. And you know why?
Yes, Tatanka is on the inside.
No, it's because Macho Man Savage has bought all the copies. He's so embarrassed of the picture.
Well, I don't know that to be true. Nonetheless, I'll agree with you that it's unquestionably the hottest-selling edition of the WWF magazine ever. Tatanka is on the warpath. Sanchez now back up to his feet. Maybe not for long. No, apparently not. Tatanka with Sanchez. Exactly where he wants to go to the canvas.
He'll never get the model in that position.
I don't know about that. Time will tell. Tatanka on his way to WrestleMania.
Ladies and gentlemen, the immortal Hulk Hogan.
WrestleMania, 2 weeks away from your one-on-one encounter with Sid Justice.
Well, you know something, Mean Gene. When you say 2 weeks away, brother, that sounds like an eternity to me, man. That sounds like forever and a day before I get to face Sid Justice one-on-one. But you know something, Hulkamaniacs? This is different, brothers. This is different than any other WrestleMania we've had before us. Sid Justice, my God, is out of control, brother. When I look in his eyes, I see that ice-cold look, just like the ice-cold veins that runs up through his arms, man. But I had to think about it. I've seen the look somewhere before. That's why I looked at the press conference over and over again until I had it. And then I realized, brothers, brother Hulkamaniacs, that that look in Sid Justice's eyes is the same look as the Jeffrey Dahmers of the world and the Mansons of the world. This guy is demented, Mean Gene. You saw what just happened to Virgil out there. Can you imagine if he would have keyed off on Brutus, if he would have made contact? Can you imagine what would happen to Brutus's face? And think about it. Between now and WrestleMania, with Sid Justice out of control, think about what might happen between now and then. Sid Justice, he says that he rules the world, Mean Gene. Well, maybe he rules Sid Justice's world. But when it comes down to WrestleMania, when you step in front of the Hoosier Dome with all my maniacs as your judge, that's where Hulk Hogan rules. That's where the four commandments of the training, the prayers, the vitamins, and the believing in ourselves rules. So Sid Justice, when you feel the power of Hulkamania, brother, when you realize what Hulk Hogan's all about, in WrestleMania 8, with God as my witness, I swear, brother, I'll prove you the power of Hulkamania. And what you're gonna do when the Hulkster puts his own brand of justice on you?
Virgil, you are complaining about your broken nose. Well, Sid Justice has no compassion for any living soul. And you, Hogan, how convenient for you to spread the rumor that Mania will be your last event. When you signed that match, I was the one that decided that for you. Because I am the one that rules the world.
I've done my time, boss man. My sentence is almost up. And soon, real soon, you're gonna pay. Then I'll be completely rehabilitated.
You know something, Sid Justice? This is WrestleMania 8, brother. And the old man with the yellow boots has been around the block a few times. You know, you're just not the first big man that's tried to rattle my cage and flip my world upside down, brother. There's Yandre the Giant's man. There's all the big monsters that I've left laying. And you know something? After what you did to Virgil, the way you busted his nose wide open, it's quite obvious what you're here for, brother. But you picked the wrong man at the wrong time. All the speculation about Hulk Hogan maybe having his last match, I've heard that for years. My God, how long can one man stay on top of the world? Well, just as long as those little teeny Hulksters want me to. And Sid Justice, since you said my destiny has already been written, brother, and that this will be my last match, brother, I'm going to heed your word, and I'm going to fight you tooth and nail, just like this is my last match. What you going to do? Who lies, Ric Flair? Totally 1,000,000% untrue. Do you understand that? Yeah. Tainted her reputation. Elizabeth's reputation. You tainted her. Yeah. And suffered an indignation. Yeah. And gave her 1,000,000% humiliation, Ric Flair. And for that, you will pay. Yeah, you will. You will pay, Ric Flair. In the Hoosier Dome. At WrestleMania 8. You gotta understand that I will take it right to you, yeah. At the moment of truth, I will whoop you and beat you, and you will face the truth, yeah.
When WWF champion Ric Flair bought us the photos, we had no reason to believe they're anything less than genuine. We tried to contact the Savages, they were on vacation. They were unavailable. Press time was upon us, we had to go to press. However, if the Savages have any proof that these photographs are not genuine, it is our responsibility as journalists to give them full and free forum in WWF magazine.
The action continues here in Mobile, Alabama at the Mobile Civic Center. What, Alfred Hayes, so far we have seen some tremendous bouts. to continue right here, though.
A strong, powerful man, the Mountie, coming in. But a very strong, powerful manager also. Or should I say mouthpiece.
Well, now, Fernandez, this is the first time I have heard this astute tune that the Mountie is obviously very pleased with. I think the title of that song is The Mountie Always Gets His Man. I'll tell you what, Lord Alfred Hayes, he's going to have a very tough time today. I do believe this is going to be a classic encounter, Your Lordship, as Bret the Hitman Hart gets ready to lock up with the superstar who took the Intercontinental belt away from him. Now, this may not be for a title, but folks, this is a grudge match.
Oh, it's a clash indeed. And I must say now that Bret Hart is the most flawless wrestler in the World Wrestling Federation since Mr. Perfect is on a hiatus. So I'm really looking forward to seeing this particular man pitch all his skills, all his finesse against the Mountie, who is a very strong, powerful wrestler indeed. But will that be enough to overcome the skills of his adversary here, the former Intercontinental Champion, Bret Hart?
The question remains, Lord Alfred Hayes, can the Hitman get past the emotional part of this encounter? You know he has been seething since that loss in Springfield, Massachusetts, when he was suffering from a 104-degree fever. And the Mountie took advantage of the situation and took his title. Can he concentrate? Not lose control here, letting his anger get the best of him. So far, it is skill that is getting the best of the Mountie.
He's really punishing his man. Bret Hart is not really paying attention to the finer arts of wrestling. He just wants to punish the Mountie. My goodness, did he ever clobber him just then. He hit him with everything except the kitchen sink.
I think they're heading back to the locker room.
Well, that's no good. No money there. I'm sure Hart, the skin flint in him, will make him cajole his man back into the ring again.
Didn't really hear the exchange that took place between those two men, but sure, Jimmy Hart mentioned the fact that money would be lost if he headed back to the locker room.
Yes.
The Mountie back in, tries to seek a quick escape. Atomic drop. Got nowhere to go at this point. Clothesline drops him. And the Mountie at this point just wants out of there.
Yes, he's seeking to grab hold of anything to stop this punishment and this terrible situation that has befallen him. What a difference today from when Hart stepped into the ring with that 104-degree temperature last time these two encountered each other.
Lord Alfred Hayes, we are now just 2 weeks away, actually less than 2 weeks away, from the biggest event of 1992, WrestleMania 8. As you know, the Hitman is going to have his chance to reclaim the Intercontinental title when he faces Rowdy Roddy Piper. So he could settle two scores in the matter of 2 weeks here.
I'm sure he could. You know, Piper is a very, very confident champion. His words tell us that he has that tremendous confidence of a champion. But look at Bret Hart. He is really at the top of his form. If he can keep this up for another 2 weeks, I'm sure he'll achieve those two objects that you were just talking about, Sean.
Mountie's head driven into the turnbuckle numerous times. Tough staying on his feet at this point. As the Hitman continues. But he is driven in hard into the turnbuckle there. I think the whole ring moved.
I think it did. I think it moved at least 3 or 4 inches. He shifted the whole of that heavy, heavy tonnage back there with that tremendous burst. It must have really shaken
him. He's got him right where he wants him. Remember one thing.
Oh, the Mountie of the South spewing at ringside.
Well,
you know what, Alfred Hayes?
Listen to that.
A very tense situation right now between the Hitman and Rowdy Roddy Piper. They were at one time very close friends, but The Intercontinental Championship has changed all that.
Well, you know something, Sean, I really feel that Piper extended his hand in friendship, but Brett is a man's man, and he won't take that. He would rather remain on that neutral ground, have no friends, but sadly has enemies. And I think that Piper realizes that, and they will both come in on April the 5th, Sunday afternoon, at WrestleMania 8, much prepared to go at each other, Hammer and Tom.
Lord Alfred Hayes, it is very difficult to remain friends when you are preparing for war. Folks, you can see it all live on pay-per-view, and that is just one of the great encounters taking place. About the double main event. Maybe the last time we ever see Hulk Hogan involved in a matchup here in the World Wrestling Federation, Lord Alfred Hayes.
Yeah, it could possibly be that. You know, Sean, for those people who are in that Midwest territory, to get down to the Hoosier Dome is just a tremendous thing, you know. It's the home of champions, and I'm sure we're going to see history there. And
wait a minute. Sensational Sharian Shawn Michaels heading out to the ring. I didn't know there was any alliance here between the Mountie and a very confident Shawn Michaels. What is going on?
I wouldn't trust Shawn Michaels as far as I could throw him, and that's not very far indeed. But if the Mountie's going to place some trust in this fellow, you better watch his back.
Perhaps Shawn Michaels and Sensational Sherry are merely scouting out the competition.
I think that's what it is, quite honestly.
Sure, Michaels must realize that in less than 2 weeks, the Hitman could once again be in possession. Didn't quite catch that conversation.
No, he was talking about the excitement. Well, that's for sure. There's a lot of excitement in this match, as you can tell by the crowd reaction. Great, great stuff there by Hart.
Backbreaker, and the Mountie hurting at this point, despite the presence of Shawn Michaels. Bret Hart keeps up the assault, not letting up one bit.
And Hart doing the right thing, not paying any attention whatsoever to that outside presence of Michaels and Sensational Sherry. He's doing the right thing.
Strutting back and forth. And now the battle is taking place outside of the ring. Shawn Michaels getting very close to the action. He had better keep his distance. This could turn into a brawl. Mountie sent back into the ring. And
oh, look at Hart keeping a weather eye open there for Michaels. And it's about time the referee said something. Davis just hanging up and being cool, did he say?
Yeah. Hang out back in the locker room.
Yes, and be cool there. Might be a draft back there somewhere that he could be cooler with.
Michael's definitely serving as a very distracting presence.
I like this. Look at Hart. He's maneuvering the battle away from Michael. Now he's in a danger. He's vulnerable right now.
Michael's now backing up. Bret Hart. Yeah, you want a piece of me? Come on. Oh. What up, Alfred Hayes? We have a bell, I do believe. Well, let's get the official word.
The referee has awarded this bout as a result of a countout to the Mountie.
Well, as a result of the distraction provided by Shawn Michaels, Bret Hart will be denied revenge today in this encounter against the Mountie. And Lord Alfred Hayes, I'm sure you will agree, Shawn Michaels had absolutely no business at ringside in this encounter. It looks as though something may have started between these two superstars.
How does it feel, Virgil, to not be able to breathe with that broken nose? You like that stupid Brutus! You got in my way, and you suffered the consequences, didn't you? So in the World Wrestling Federation, I have a question to ask you. How do you like your little blue-eyed boy they call Mr. Death Hogan? And death it will be, because it will be the death of Hulkamania and Mania. And I will be the one to cause it. Why? Because it's simple. I rule the world.
Roddy Piper, it's less than 2 weeks away. We're not going to hide behind any reputations. And we're not going to worry about that friendship, are we? It's all coming to a head. I was in a dressing room a couple of days ago, and an old-timer came up to me, and he told me what a tough fighter you are, that you're one of the toughest, maybe the toughest fighter that there is. But he also told me one thing. A good wrestler can beat a good fighter any time. And that old-timer was my father. In a WrestleMania 8, Roddy Piper, I'm going to take the Intercontinental belt back.
2 weeks. 2 weeks away from WrestleMania, Bret Hart. It ain't time. I'd still like to be your friend. If you want to back out now, we can be friends. If you don't, if you're going to persist on the line you have been, if you are going to come on, remember, I don't take no dives. I don't pull no punches. I'm Roddy Piper. I feed my family this way. I flatlined half my life. Hart,
we'll see how much heart you got.
Just 2 weeks away, Erwin. 2 weeks away from WrestleMania 8, and there's been a whole lot of grumbling and rumbling and blowing hot air between Typhoon and the Earthquake. They're out seeking revenge. They want to get even with us, and the truth is, you were just stupid. Poor businessmen. These belts would be around your waist if you've been a little bit smarter. The only thing shaking on April the 5th is going to be your knees.
And everybody out there knows that IRS's favorite month is April. That means April 15th, you're going to have to pay your tax, you tax cheat.
Money Incorporated and Jimmy Hart, you've bought yourself into the disaster area. And in 2 weeks at WrestleMania, you're going to feel the full wrath of the natural disaster.
That's right, Money Inc. Come WrestleMania, we're taking and auditing the IRS. And DiBiase, we're cleaning out your account. And you beady-eyed little cockroach.
We're gonna step all over you.
Could I get your attention, please? Before we get started here tonight, I would like to set some ground rules down for everybody, members of the dais as well. And the ground rules are this, that I would like all the applause to be held till after Ric Flair has finished speaking. Now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I would like to introduce to you the man that in 1 week at WrestleMania 8 will face the Macho Man Randy Savage. And I am proud to say will destroy the Macho Man Randy Savage. Ladies and gentlemen, I give to you at this time the greatest World Wrestling Federation champion of all time, Ric Flair.
Thank you, Mr. Perfect. As I now stand before each and every one of you, each and every one of you that believes Elizabeth led that life of celibacy, each and every one of you that believes she's that sweet, innocent flower she claims to be, each and every one of you that believes her accusations that the photographs of she and I are not real, once again, as I stand before you all, let's just take one moment to review the photos. Let's start out with the photo of she and I by the pool. Remember the towels? The initials R and L, well, what else could they stand for but Rick and Liz? And my favorite fruit, strawberries. What a great day that was. Now let's look at Liz and I watching TV, cuddled up oh so closely. And of course, there's the scene at the dining room table, drinking Dom Perignon. Look at the look of her eyes. Look at the bliss of there's a satisfied woman. And of course, let's go to the stable. As I said earlier, there's Elizabeth with her two favorite studs. Please notice the scarf she's wearing. Well, it's not by chance, ladies and gentlemen, that I happen to have that lovely scarf with me this very moment. And it's not by chance that I happen to remember the lovely scent of Elizabeth, Randy, the lovely scent of your oh-so-beautiful wife. Then again, it's not by chance that I'll be wearing this same scarf at WrestleMania 8. remembering the sweet smell of your lovely wife, Randy. And it's not by chance that I will experience the sweet smell of success when I beat you, Randy Savage, at WrestleMania 8. Woo! Thank you. Thank you all so much. Woo!
My God, Sid Justice, now that WrestleMania's winding down, brother, as I study the tapes, I see the power you possess, big man, the way you handle two or three opponents at a time. Your poetry in motion with power personified, brother. And as your opponents tremble at your feet, big man, I see so much of me in you, brother. In the early days, man, when I was hungry, scratching, vying for a shot at the top. But thank God, brother, when that fork in the road came, I went to the right. I made the right decision. But as far as you, Sid Justice, you've been hanging a hard left, man. So I'm going to shoot on the square with you, big man. I'm going to tell you the facts of life. There's no substitution for experience, brother, for paying your dues and putting your time in, big man. Because in WrestleMania, when we're in front of 72,000 people, I'm going to prove that the power of Hulkamania, the Four Commandments, the decade of love and devotion is going to put you in your place, brother. Number one, I'm going to teach you the wrestling lesson of your life. Number two, after I beat you and satisfy all the Hulkamaniacs, I'm going to get off by cranking your knob just a little beyond the breaking point. And number three, when all's said and done in the Hoosier Dome, I'm going to take your pride and wipe the mat with it. What you going to do when the greatest wrestler in the largest arms of all times run wild on you?
Another day. Another day closer. Another day closer to getting out of here and coming for you, boss man.
Who the heck was that?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Somebody locked away in prison, it looks like to me, monster.
You're a journalist, aren't you? That's what you claim to be.
Hey, I don't know anything about jail.
Find out! Well, don't yell at me. I got mess to talk about.
You don't know anything about jail. You could be going there soon.
For what?
Natural disaster! Those aren't my pictures. I told you that.
For lying and cheating.
I'll tell you something about the natural disasters. If they want to defeat Money Incorporated, DiBiase, and IRS to win the WWF title, they better not concern themselves with Jimmy Hart, the shrewd businessman as he is.
What do you mean, if they want to beat?
What I mean, if they want to win.
You don't think they want it badly?
Well, then
you don't
think
they want to get their hands on that little runt?
Well, then they're going to have to concern themselves, like I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted by you.
I'll tell you right now, they better have the championship belts enlarged. Because these guys are going to have to wear them.
Well, if anybody could beat IRS and DiBiase, it's these two. And they want to get their hands so bad on Jimmy Hart. They feel Jimmy Hart took away the title shot. They feel that they should have been the WWF tag team.
That's correct.
Don't interrupt me.
You're upset, aren't you, Brad?
I'm not upset about
nothing. I can tell when you get flustered.
No, you can't.
You're a little bit paranoid, too.
I am, too. You are not.
If I were in your shoes, I'd be worried.
Of course. My shoes wouldn't fit you. Your feet would hurt.
This is going to be a classic matchup at the Hoosier Dome. Be part of it. The only way to go right now, pick up that phone, call your local cable company. Pay-per-view is the answer.
We're going to have to get about seven or eight more cows to put more leather on that belt to fit these two.
Whoa.
Yeah, you don't want to sit home the next day and miss WrestleMania, have some humanoid come over to borrow a cup of sugar and a half a pound of lard and say, hey, did you missed it last night, Herbie.
Come on, bro.
It was a great, great WrestleMania.
What? Oh, gee, I didn't know about it.
What are you making with a cup of sugar and a half a pound of lard?
Humanoid food.
Is that some weasel,
not weasel
entree?
No, it's natural disaster chow.
Or you're getting ready for what they feed you in the slammer.
I'm not going to this. I don't know who that guy was talking about, the big boss man, but I tell you one thing, boss man's going to be in trouble if that guy ever hits the wall.
These two are ready, and ready indeed. They're right on top of their game.
Whoa!
Avalanche in the corner. Mm. Boy, they are excited about the Hoosier Dome, and rightly so. A golden opportunity for them to become WWF Tag Team Champions.
In front of 75,000 people, and probably the biggest television audience in the history of pay-per-views. Yeah, I'd say they're excited. They better be excited, but they better concentrate on Money Incorporated, because that's who they're going to have to beat. Not 75,000 humanoids and people all over the world. They got to...
WrestleMania,
you know what I mean,
will in fact be going all over the world. France, Germany, Italy, Spain, Norway, Sweden, Denmark, Zimbabwe, whoa, Singapore, just to name a few places.
Zimbabwe, I'm not going there.
You might have to hide out there.
The natural disasters.
Natural disasters headed for the Hoosier Dome. Looking forward to it. If you want to be part of WrestleMania, here's how you can.
Gentlemen, my guest at this time, the current reigning World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, along with their manager, Jimmy Hart, here's Money Incorporated.
They are the temporary champions. Look, natural disaster still in the ring.
Sure, these guys blocked their way. Why didn't they just wait a minute?
Something could happen here, Money. Huh. Watch this.
Everybody's gonna pay.
All right, we are 1 week away from WrestleMania. In that extravaganza, Jimmy Hart, IRS, Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase, will be defending the belts against the natural disaster.
You know, Mean Gene, baby, there's an old saying, and it's money talks, and Jimmy Hart, baby, took a walk. I took a walk right out of the lives of the natural disasters and right into the lives of Money Incorporated.
You sold them out. You sold them down a river. No doubt about that.
It's obvious the natural disasters made a big mistake. They're going to get beat in WrestleMania. WrestleMania is a money-making venture, and there's no way Money, Inc. is going to lose.
All right.
That's right, Okerlund. And this big, fat typhoon and earthquake have been shaking, quaking, blowing a lot of hot air about how they want revenge with us. Well, the simple fact is, you made a bad business move. If you were as smart as you are big, these belts would be around your waist now. But they're not. And at WrestleMania, nothing's going to change because it's all about money, and we're keeping the money and the belts.
Well, I'll tell you what. I think, Jimmy Hart, this is all going to come back to haunt you. You'd have to agree with me on that, Irwin.
I don't have to agree with you on anything. April 5th. Natural disasters are going to get beat in WrestleMania. And then April 15th, they have to pay their taxes. I don't think April is going to be a very good month.
You better get some officials down here. Jimmy, get them moving. Get them out of there.
April 5th is coming early. Oh, look at them run like thieves in the night.
Rick Martel. You have crossed my path and humiliated the great Indian nations. And at WrestleMania, I will revenge my people and make them proud as their new leader.
Tatanka, it's obvious by the way you attacked me as I was leaving the ring that you are on the warpath. Well, that's fine with me, because at WrestleMania, when that warpath comes my direction, it will be paved over by the Model Express.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
We're here in Biloxi, Mississippi. Gorilla Monsoon along with Bobby the Brain Heenan for this tremendous matchup between the Hot Rod, reigning Intercontinental Champion, and that guy right there, Shawn Michaels.
And he's got his sights set on the winner of the Rowdy Roddy Piper Bret Hart match at WrestleMania 8.
And he doesn't care 5th. Which one either.
Doesn't care. But he has the advantage here because he's wrestling Piper right now. And should Piper retain the title, he'll have a little bit of an edge on Piper because he'll know what Piper's all about.
You know, Brian, I'm very
surprised that the Hot Rod took a match of this magnitude this close to WrestleMania 8.
Well, had I been managing the Intercontinental Champion this
time, would he be in trouble?
I would have told him not to take any match at all. But that shows you the kind of a guy Piper is. He wants to get out there and fight.
Oh, look at that shot. He's something, Monsoon. He's got some tremendous wrestling skills and abilities, no denying that. Of course, that leech, that hang-on that's out there with him could be a detriment sooner or later.
Who are you referring to?
Sensational Jerry. Oh, listen to the ovation here for the Hot Rod, reigning Intercontinental Champion.
I wonder if he'll be smiling after his match with Bret Hart at WrestleMania.
What a matchup that's going to be. Hot Rod bowing determinedly to hold on to that gold. Boy, that's the only belt he's ever held, right?
He should have two belts. That one and one across his mouth.
Will you stop? Got to keep an eye on the...
Hey, what a classy move, huh?
What was that? I missed that. You care to expound on
it? No.
Supposed to be a journalist, you know.
I only report on things that are positive, not negative. There's something positive.
Yeah. Positive to empty your bank account. Roddy number one is the chant here in Biloxi.
But look at the confidence in Shawn Michaels. This man is a future champion and the star of the 90s.
Look at her. What's she going to do now?
Tempt him like she does all the men.
Get out of there.
Checking out the knees. Yep, they're covered. He's got knee pads on, hon.
She's disgusting.
She is in love. Soon she loves...
She loves money and loves herself. And now she's found a new meal ticket.
Piper trying to get her attention. But you're going to get Shawn Michaels' attention, Mr. Piper.
You know, I've heard her say a thousand times, Brain, I'm in love with Shawn Michaels. I haven't heard one time Shawn Michaels say, I'm in love with her.
A man doesn't have to tell a woman he's in love with him. Huh. And a woman doesn't need to know it. All they want to see is that
Hot Rod right in his face.
That gold express card. Should never tell a woman he loves her. Let her earn it.
Oh, please. Everything's a one-way street with you, Brain.
And I control the flashing red light.
Come on, ref, ring the bell. Let's get this thing going. Here we go.
This is going to be a heck of a match.
You want to bet she'll stick her nose in sooner or later?
Whoa! That's a class move, Piper, spitting in a man's face.
All righty, from the streets. Former Golden Gloves champion. You don't want to mix it up with a fist of cups with him. Whoa. What's wrong with Michaels? He's got all that speed, all that agility. He's playing right into Piper's hands.
He is playing Piper's game. That's not right.
Oh! We agreed on something. We're in trouble.
No, don't let him get away.
Listen to the screaming Mimi.
Sherry, not
over
Mimi.
Over the top, golf Michaels, high cross body. Oh, look at Piper turn it over. Two count is all he could get. Shot into the corner.
He hit the post.
Could be all over. Round two now.
That shows you how tough and gutsy this Michaels is. I'm not sure he knows where he's at right now.
He don't have a clue. Oh, look at this. I told you she'd get involved, Brain. She's up there. What's Rod gonna do?
Oh, my God.
Paul McMahon. You need a hoping
She will be right the shots. Boy, she's in shock. She got one planted on her. Whoa. A real man. I'll tell you, before I kiss Piper, I'd rather kiss a hospital mop. He really shocked her. Oh, right into the steel step. Well, Piper, how do you like kissing the floor? Right in his kisser. It's a play, though. Part of the strategy they work out. Watch this. I know what he's going to do. He's going to nail him off that apron. See? Look out from behind. Kisser again, Piper. Shawn Michaels out for double axe handle right between the eyes.
Do I know what I'm talking about, or don't I?
Sometimes you surprise me, Brian. And he'll keep coming. You're not going to make the guy give up. You're going to have to pin him.
Absolutely.
He won't quit. But he's a human being. He's a punk. He can be beat.
You're talking about the reigning Intercontinental Champion.
Now, he might not have it after April 5th in Indianapolis, WrestleMania 8. The Hitman may be once again Intercontinental Champion.
What a matchup that's going to be. You won't want to miss it. Be part of the big one. Two count here. The only way to do that right now is on a pay-per-view basis. So don't get left out. Pick up that phone. Call your local cable company. Be part of the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time.
You know, if there wasn't the Intercontinental title at stake and Piper was wrestling Bret Hart, it'd be a great scientific match. But you know it's going to happen. They're going to get in that ring and they're going to start wrestling. But tempers are going to boil. It's going to explode. It's just going to be a fight.
Expect it to be one of the biggest matches of the afternoon.
I predict it to be one of the biggest matches in World Wrestling Federation history.
Nice reversal, but Hot Rod underneath the clothesline, but oh, caught the reverse crescent kick right into Kisser.
And you know they're both about the same size, same weight.
Absolutely not. You'll come up with a short end of the stick.
You know, WrestleMania 2, he knocked out Mr. T, didn't he?
Certainly did. Flatten that bum.
Whoa! Whoa! 3 points through the uprights.
It's field goal time in Biloxi. Where is she?
Whoa!
Concerned about her man now.
I would say
they could do a soprano alto duet.
What a match this is, huh?
Oh, Hot Rod went for a bulldog. Shawn Michaels threw him off, and Piper wiped out the referee.
Now, is the title at stake here?
No, this is a non-title matchup.
Oh, darn it.
Look, what is this?
Somebody a hand and letting him up a foot. Same thing.
Look out, Hot Rod! Oh, just leveled him. I believe he knocked him out.
He's out. I'll count. One.
Nobody there to count. Referee still semi-conscious.
I don't think it matters. Uh-oh.
Hitman on his way down.
He's going to help Shawn Michaels put the boots to Roddy Piper.
He is not. Swing, but he missed.
Uh-oh. What is going on now?
The referee caught Hot Rod with a boot.
Well, he should have.
Yes, it's a disqualification.
Here's your winner as the result of a disqualification, Shawn Michaels.
Good call, ref.
Oh, will you stop?
Well, he got caught. Doesn't matter what you do if you don't get caught.
see. Wait a minute. Piper's blaming him for losing the match now.
Everything you did has got me disqualified. You stay out of my life. You understand me? Am I making myself clear?
What's he blaming him for?
If you don't like it, do something about it.
Piper's blaming him for losing the match. He said, stay out of my life. Bret Hart, I know what Bret Hart was doing. He didn't want to see Piper hurt. He wants him fresh in WrestleMania to defend that title.
All right, you can only stay out of his life until April 5th.
I'm telling you,
and then he's going to be right in your face.
It's starting to boil right now. I can smell it cooking.
What an intercontinental matchup that's going to be in the Hoosier Dome on April 5th, WrestleMania 8. It's going to be a classic. Right now, let's take you back to Vince McMahon.
Who?
Brain, I still have my doubts about those photos. Something stinks here.
Hey,
has Elizabeth said anything?
Not
yet.
Well,
I sure would have said something if somebody had pictures of me that weren't true. The reason she hasn't said anything is because there's nothing she can say. It's proof.
Going on straight along with Bobby the Brain, Heenan here in Biloxi, as we listen to the lovely Mike McGurk introduce WWF champion Ric Flair.
The lovely Mike McGurk. She's the only woman I know that's been using the Thigh Master on her face.
Will you stop?
Federation champion, Ric Flair!
Woo! My man!
Not a whole lot of time left for Slick to walk around with the gold around his waist.
Slick, Ric.
Well, you call him what you want, I'll call him what I want.
And Mr. Perfect. There's another confident individual.
Yeah, he's perfect. He lies and Flair swears to it.
That's cool. Oh, Ric Flair has a robe made he's going to be wearing at WrestleMania 8 in Indianapolis. A red one. You won't believe this monsoon costs him $50,000.
Well, maybe he'll only get to wear it once.
Wait till you... What do you mean?
Well, Macho Man, in my opinion, is going to walk out of the Hoosier Dome as once again reigning WWF champion.
Wait till you see him walk down that aisle. That's cool.
I thought you'd be more upset, Brain. You're on the list. You're on the hit list.
On what list? I'm not on any list.
Oh, yes, you are.
For what?
You're on the hit list of the Macho Man.
You're going to put me on a list? Put
for
me on
all
the...
that photo garbage you've been laying on everybody.
Hey, they're not my photos. They belong to Flair.
Hey, too bad.
You talk to him about
your name right on top of the list. Ric Flair, the reigning champion, and that man right there.
Well, then you talk
the
to
the executive consultant.
You talk to Mr. Perfect about
and
that.
Also,
you talk to Flair about that.
The publisher of the magazine as well.
Well, he should be on the list. But Elizabeth hadn't even said anything. Just because Savage denies it doesn't mean anything.
Well, for your edification, Brain, coming up next on the program will be the First Lady of the World Wrestling Federation with a special interview.
Well, you don't have to show that. We've seen her lie before.
We are. Brunzel with a side headlock here on the champ.
Hey, one thing about Brunzel, he's always in tremendous shape. And he looks good in that ring. He's a competitor.
Possessing one of the most tremendous drop kicks I've ever seen.
I've known this man his career since he started.
Oh, shot right in the eye.
Only one trouble he has, Brunzel.
What is that?
Oh, he tries to make everybody like him. He wants to be a nice human being. That won't help you, dummy. You got to get out there and kick somebody when they're down.
One half of the big double main event coming up at WrestleMania 8. Ric Flair taking on the Macho Man Randy Savage. And the other half, the Hulkster, taking on Insane Sid Justice. You want to know everything about WrestleMania 8? Call the WrestleMania 8 hotline at 1-900-909-WWF-8. $1.49 for the first minute. Only 99 cents for each additional minute. You youngsters out there, you kiddies, be sure and ask mom and dad before you call that hotline number.
Are you sure I can't call collect?
Will you stop?
Well, I left my wallet in my other pants.
When did you ever hear of a 900 number you could call collect?
Okay, then loan me $1.49.
Get
I'll pay you best. You deadbeat.
Over for the cover, 2-0. Very nonchalant cover by Ric Flair.
You go tell him that. That's a WWF champion there you're calling nonchalant.
Inverted atomic drop finds the mark.
Give it a woo. I'll do it for you.
Woo! There'll be a whole lot of oh yeahs in the Hoosier Dome.
What is Elizabeth possibly going to say?
I don't know, Brain.
If I did, I wouldn't tell you. I know what she's going to say. She's going to announce that she's filed for divorce.
Oh, please. Why don't you be serious? Come down to earth.
When you're watching...
I know there's 40 on the list, and your name is right at the
top. Well, my name is no reason to be there.
It's a vendetta now. Oh, look at that. What a backdrop.
I wouldn't have taken this match so close to WrestleMania, especially with a competitor. Oh,
there's that drop kick we talked about.
No.
On two. Incidentally, this is also a non-title matchup.
Yeah, but you can get hurt with a guy like Renzel in there.
Certainly can. Nice reversal and a sleeper. Nice move by the champ.
The beginning of the end.
Here it comes. That patented figure four leg lock.
Snap, crackle, and pop. He said it. He's from Minnesota. He's a quitter. I knew that. He'd give it up. That's cool.
That's got nothing to do with it. Where you're from, give me a break.
Sure does. We don't quit Beverly Hills. We hire people
Wrestling
to report.
Federation champion, Rick Flair. Stay with
Elizabeth, thank you for allowing us into your home.
Well, Vince, 2 weeks ago when you were here, I couldn't speak with you then. I was in shock. I was embarrassed and humiliated. And I guess what I've been feeling is a little numb. But now I'm angry. I'm angry because national television and the World Wrestling Federation magazine, a publication that has always treated Randy and myself fairly, publisher. I don't know how those photographs happened, and I can't believe is that someone like Ric Flair would be taken at face value for what he said. It just amazes me. I'm really angry about it.
Are you saying that in the negatives, which Randy Savage now has, are you saying that in those negatives, where you see Ric Flair next to you, that it's actually Randy Savage? That's what the negatives are going to show?
Absolutely. I don't know how he did it, how Ric Flair managed to do it, but those are personal pictures of Randy and mine, and I'm so upset that he was able to do that, and then that the magazine would just publish them, that they were true.
Do you feel as though your reputation has been besmirched in any way?
Oh, of course I do. I feel terrible about it. I feel badly, not just for myself, but for my family and for Randy's family, that everyone now is looking at us a little bit differently.
Are you different, Liz?
I think I'm probably, yes, a lot different. I think what's more important is the idea that this can happen to anyone, that a person like Ric Flair can say something is true and people believe it, and it can happen to anyone at any time. It's just shocking.
So you feel vulnerable then?
I feel vulnerable. I think, I'd say I feel pretty vulnerable.
What do you want to happen, Liz, if you could wave your magic wand and all this goes away? How are you going to be vindicated?
I know that we will be vindicated when the magazine publishes the true photographs, when I know that when people get a chance to actually see what the true story is, that I personally will feel vindicated. But there will always kind of be a nagging in my mind that anyone would ever believe that this happened.
So then you feel you've been scarred, and perhaps in some way, scarred for life.
Yes.
Thank you.
You know, I would have to be the first to admit that tribute to Hulk Hogan and Hulk Hogan himself in his day was maybe the greatest wrestler there ever was. And even myself, that has no compassion for no living soul, Hogan, for just a second, one second, I feel sorry for you. Because you, Hogan, are now facing something you have never faced before.
power. You are facing a fuel-injected suicide machine that is called Sid Justice. Now, that feeling in your gut that's running through your veins, you call that feeling what you want, but it is called fear. Fear from the man that rules the world.
When it comes crashing down and it hurts.
With us now, ladies and gentlemen, the man who at WrestleMania 8 will face Sid Justice, here is Hulk Hogan. Hulkster, thank you for joining us. I wonder if you'd comment on your impending match in approximately a week with Sid Justice.
Yeah, I'd like to talk about Sid Justice. But when you comment on a match of this magnitude, it really boxes myself and all the little Hulkamaniacs in a corner. The match with Andre the Giant, the Ultimate Warrior match, Macho Man Randy Savage, in every war, every test we've ever won or fought hard in, doesn't mean a thing at this point in time. Because the threat of Sid Justice in the WWF means not only is the whole WWF under pressure, but the whole theme of Hulkamania, the four demands we've talked about, could cease to exist if a man like Sid Justice has his way with me in the ring. It's the final test for me, Vince McMahon. And that test means I'm on the edge of greatness or I'm on the edge of disaster. But Sid Justice in WrestleMania, you're going to feel Hulkamania at its highest peak, at its strongest power. And when you step in the ring with me and all my maniacs, you better be everything that you say you are, brother, because I'm everything that I say I am. And when you test the power of Hulkamania, realize that it's a test of time. It's something that's been established, something that everybody believes in, especially the little Hulkamaniacs. And to beat me, this time in WrestleMania, you're going to have to beat everybody that believes in positive thoughts, positive deeds, and I just don't think you can do it.
Well, let me ask you, we know what Hulkamania means to us, but what does Hulkamania mean to you?
Hulkamania is a standard. It's something intangible that you have to fight all your life to achieve. It's a goal that I set for myself and all my Hulkamaniacs, realizing that the goal was so far out there that you'd have to fight every moment of the day to get as close to that goal as you could. Hulk Hogan, the man, becomes better every day just by realizing the four demands of Hulkamania, the prayers, the vitamins, the training, the believing in yourself. We keep striving to be the perfect, the ultimate Hulkamaniac, but we set the goal so high that anything less than 100% commitment, total dedication, is classified as failure if you're really a Hulkamaniac. This is something that will make your life better each and every day. So when I think about Sid Justice and the fact that he puts everything in jeopardy that I've fought for, that all these kids believe in, it makes me think that Sid Justice doesn't realize what he's really getting in the ring with. We're fighting for different reasons. I mean, I'm shooting for happiness, peace of mind in my personal life and my professional life. Sid Justice, when I look at him, maybe I'm judging him too soon, but to me, he's just another guy with a big mouth and a big body that's trying to take a shortcut to the top. But that's where the buck stops, because whenever you take a shortcut around the WWF, you end up running into Hulk Hogan.
Then is this your last match, this WrestleMania? Is this the last time we see you step into the ring?
When you ask that question, it makes me sweat. Everywhere I've been, people say, Hulk Hogan, we know you've got a lot of things going. You're starting to divide your interests. You've got family, you've got business, wrestling business, you've got other type of ventures out there. Are you going to retire? Then I hear on the other side of the coin, are you going to be able to get by Sid Justice? When I sit here and actually think about my last match at WrestleMania, it chills me to the bone. Being able to handle happiness within my personal life and happiness on a professional level has been one of the greatest accomplishments that I could brag about. So when I talk about letting all that go, putting all that in jeopardy by saying, yes, this is my last match, or by even letting someone influenced me, such as Sid Justice, saying, Hulk Hogan, I'm going to make sure this is your last match. All those thoughts I put out of my head. I'm the only one that can make that decision, Vince McMahon. And right now, I have to tell you, at WrestleMania, I just won't know until I come out of the ring if it was my last match.
Well, then, whether or not this is your last match, I'd like to say that on behalf of all of us, your Hulkamaniacs, thank you for the memories, thank you for the inspiration, and thank you for Hulkamania.
Thank you.